Johnson & Johnson has decided to stop selling their skin whitening creams. Unilever has decided to change their classic product Fair & Lovely to Glow & Lovely. Shaadi.com, India's favorite matrimony website, decided to remove their skin tone filter from their website, where users get to choose fair, medium and dark. This is a great first step to the end of colorism, but there is so much more that you have to look over it. Hi, I am Sujata. Welcome to my channel, and today's topic is reality versus advertisements. We grew up those days seeing the TV commercials which promotes skin fairness in 14 days, whiter and fairness cream in just 14 days. Fair and Lovely, Fair Ever, so many fairness creams were targeting these 14 days strategy. And our mindset used to be that skin tones ads were promoted in such a way that if your skin tone is dark, you cannot achieve your goal. If your skin tone is dark, you cannot reach the sky. You cannot become an air hostess. You cannot be a sports person. You cannot face the world. You will not have confidence. Your success rate is going to be very bad. Commercials that we were imposed when we were growing up through these kind of fairness ads. But the reality is, changing the name from Fair and Lovely to Glow and Lovely, or Glow and the other concept, is not going to help. The main issue with these fairness cream is the ingredient of those fairness cream that we need to consider. Many countries, Fair and Lovely was first launched in 1975 in India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Singapore, Malaysia, Indonesia, Thailand, Brunei, and certain Asian countries. And in other countries, it will not be sold in a hypermarket. It will be sold in those small Asian supermarkets where they sell these Asian food items. Why is this not sold in other countries? Because most of the countries have banned these kind of fairness creams due to the ingredients that was in those fairness creams, like stearic acid derived from an animal fat, which gives this cream an oily consistency. Plus, once applied on face, it gives that powdery effect which kinds of give you that immediate effect of fairness in the very first application. The second toxic ingredient found in these fairness creams were the traces of mercury. Mercury, it's just a filament. What does it do to our skin? Mercury is helpful in skin color boosting, fades dark marks. Yes, of course, there are so many benefits of mercury, but regular use of mercury will damage your kidney and will also get into other serious skin disorders. Along with this mercury, there was another toxic ingredient which was found in which these products were banned, that is hydroquinone. Hydroquinone is another ingredient which gives you those neuropsychiatric disorders on a continuous usage, and along with the skin cancers. So these kind of ingredient is what we need to look for when buying any kind of fairness boosting ads, fairness boosting creams. But why are we so obsessed with these fairness? What does this fairness do? Why did it start? Are Indians born fair? Why are we even fond of these fairness cream? Why are we still giving importance to these fairness cream when it has been banned by other countries? It is banned by other countries like Norway. It is banned by South Africa, US, Canada, Japan, and European Union. These are the countries where these kind of fairness creams have completely banned, because giving something magical is not happening. Yes, now in India, we do have a rule that you cannot promote any kind of fairness post or any kind of skin color change, any kind of magical treatment to bring your skin tone to normal. There is a fine imposed of 50 lakh rupees and 5 years of jail imprisonment. These things happens, and this is in control now. However, I was brought up by seeing that I'm going to be dark, I'm not going to be successful. I have to be fair to be successful. I am using this cream, it is not working out for me. So am I a failure? Am I a loser? These are the thoughts which were imposed in me those days. And I'm sure you guys would have faced the same, which is not the reality. Your skin tone has got nothing to do with your success ratio. Your skin tone has got nothing to do with your achievements. Your skin tone is just a skin tone. It's not your identity. What you do is your identity. always remember that and stop believing these kind of TV commercials and stop believing these kind of ads. Instead, research, do a research, find out what is the fact. Check for the ingredients, check for the expiry date. These are the information that we need to look at, not the story that is imposed in the televisions. I hope this particular video helps to decide before buying the product, and I hope you will definitely look into it. The skin lightening products are not only problematic, and it's not only brainwashing people to feel that the fair skin is the ideal skin, fair skin is the successful skin. No, the ingredient of the skin lightening could also lead us to a different health issues, which we already have enough in our plate to deal with, not with the fairness creams. Please always ensure you check for the ingredient, you look for the ingredient, do a research on the ingredient before using that on your skin. Celebrities talking about Black Lives Matter were also once part of these kind of fairness ads campaign. So when they were part of those fairness ad campaigns, do you even think they have rights to talk about Black Lives Matter? If they had ever thought that Black Lives Matter, they wouldn't be part of these kind of campaigns. So before investing your money in any kind of skin boosting ingredient, skin tone increasing product, always think before you pick one. Hope this video helps you to decide which product to go for. I am not promoting any channels, any product here, but this is just for your education. Before selecting any product, you need to know what you are buying for, and you need to know what you're looking at. You need to know what is that you're using this for and how does that benefit you, which is very, very important in these markets today. Do not go by the advertisement strategy. It is just a campaign to attract money, not for the health. So always look good in everything, people. Until then, stay safe, stay healthy, and it's me, Sujata, signing off.